Good morning, everybody. I am Brisa Gonzalez, the principal of this wonderful campus, and I welcome you and our very special guest, former First Lady, Mrs. Laura Bush, to PSJA ISD Palmer Elementary. It's an honor to have you here today. Our students and community take pride in this beautiful campus that, thanks to the vision of our superintendent, Dr. Daniel King, and the support of our school board, was built in an area surrounded by the beautiful natural landscape that now serves as an extension of our classrooms for our students to learn from every day. Help me welcome our forward-thinking superintendent that has helped develop PSJA into the leader that it is today, Dr. Daniel King.
Good morning. What an honor. Here at PSJA, we're truly humbled by this honor, by this opportunity, by this designation of being a conservation wrangler through Texan by Nature. I want to thank our Board of Trustees for their leadership and vision and willingness to, work with us to step outside the box. And just very quickly, our Board President, Mr. Ben Garza, our Vice President, Mr. Jesse Zambrano, Mr. Jesse Vela, Mr. Jorge Zambrano, and our other board members that could not be present. But it takes, you have to have really, just the right kind of Board of Trustees, an amazing board to have these initiatives and then keep them moving forward. We really started this work, in depth about 5 years ago. And I really want to thank Mr. Alan Williams. I don't know where he is, but after Mr. Alan Williams was a community member and he had his own business working in landscaping and native scaping and things like that, particularly, and after having him stop by my office about two or three times to explain to me how we needed to take the right care of this and that and the other, I finally told him, you're visiting enough, why don't you just come work for us and, make sure we do it right. So he did. He changed careers and he came to work for us, and he's our native habitat specialist. And from that point, we kind of sat and we kind of planned out with the idea of having every campus in this district. We have 43, 44 campuses. To have every campus in this district have a native habitat space. And so we're close to halfway through that. And we couldn't do it without great partners. Very quickly, he worked We had already done a lot of, quote, projects, right, field trips, but now really a very in-depth engagement with the Santa Ana Wildlife Refuge, and then all the rest of the South Texas, all the wildlife corridor partners. And so we work with all of those. Our students are many of our students are very engaged. I was just talking to a pre-kinder teacher here before this came that was sharing with me how the pre-kinder students, 4 years old, 3 years old, enjoy going out on the trail and listening to identify the sounds of different birds and looking at plants and things like that. And so these are our learning laboratories, real-world learning laboratories for our students. And we're so excited about this. We're excited to see that through this work also that it's really sparked something that looks like it's going to begin to spread across the whole valley. But again, I want to thank everyone who works with us, all the different partners from all the different federal and state agencies, their private partners, and just so many people to name. And it's an amazing experience that the children here at this campus and then at our other campuses get to experience. But without further ado, we're very humbled. And without further ado, I would like to introduce to you former First Lady, Mrs. Laura Bush. Thank you.
Good morning. Thank you very much. Thank you, Dr. King. Thank you for your leadership of the FAR San Juan Alamo Independent School District, and thanks especially to the members of the board. You're serving your community in such really important ways. I mean, nothing is more important than serving the school children of your community. So thank you for serving on the board and for going to the trouble to make sure your schools are the best Thank you to Principal Gonzalez. I'm so happy to be here at Palmer Elementary. Your school looks terrific. I'm really happy to see the Green Jays here. You may not know it, but only in your part of the state do you get to see Green Jays. Up in Dallas, where George and I live, we don't get to see Green Jays. We have to travel down here to the southern part of our state to be able to see Green Jays, so you have a really perfect mascot for your town. The school also, Palmer, looks great. It really does. The school itself is so attractive, and I want to thank the school community, everyone, the parents and everyone who makes it sure that your schools are so great for your children. I also want to recognize Colin O'Mara, the president and CEO of the National Wildlife Federation. So thank you. And Colin, where are you based? In D.C. So stand up so everyone can see that you're... that what you're doing here is so important that somebody from the National Wildlife Federation, from the CEO, has come all the way here to South Texas to see this. Thank you for joining us here today. And Amy Luters, the Southwest Regional Director of U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. Thank you, Amy. And stand up so everyone can see. And Amy is based in Albuquerque, is that right? So once again, she's come all the way from Albuquerque, New Mexico, to be here with you. And then Cynthia Martinez, the chief of the National Wildlife Refuge System. Is she, Cynthia, thank you very much for joining us at the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Services. And where are you based? In Washington, D.C. So see, look at all these important chiefs of these different wildlife our organizations who've come all the way here. So thank you very much to all of you for joining us. I want to recognize, I think there's a group of librarians, my fellow librarians here from Far San Juan Alamo School District. Do y'all want to stand up? Thank you all to all the librarians who've joined us. I was just in Austin for the Texas Book Festival, which I helped found when George was governor. And the funds from the Texas Book Festival go to school libraries, so I want to encourage you to apply for them as soon as you can to make sure you get some money from the Texas Book Festival. Thank you all for joining us. To everyone, thanks to everyone who's gathered here today to join us. Thank you for joining us as we celebrate the newest Texan by Nature Conservation Wrangler, the Lower Rio Grande Valley Learning Landscapes Collaborative. President Bush are happy to be back home in Texas, living what I call the afterlife in the state that George calls the Promised Land. When we moved back to Texas from Washington, D.C., I helped found Texan by Nature with a group of friends and committed conservationists. What we want to do in our state with Texan by Nature is to spur conservation that produces tangible benefits for people, prosperity, and natural resources. And we do this by encouraging new investments in conservation that are Texan-led, community-organized, and science-based. And needless to say, that's what this is. That's why we're here, because everyone in the whole community has come together to make sure that your children go to a school where they can learn what's native, what really works down here, what are the things that we are so lucky to inherit from the people that came before us that settled here in this part of South Texas. Texan by Nature has three programs that try to engage Texans with, and one of them is our Monarch Wrangler program. It's a statewide initiative providing solutions to try to reverse the decline of this iconic butterfly. The monarch is North America's most majestic butterfly, yet the eastern population has experienced declines of up to 80% over the past decade. We're not sure why. But the monarch flies all the way from Mexico up through the flyway, the central flyway of Texas, all the way up in its migration. And we don't know if the fragmentation of land and so much agriculture or if something else has harmed the monarch. But what we're trying to do through Texan by Nature is to encourage people to plant the native milkweeds. This is what we've done at our ranch, that monarchs are, that are necessary for the life of the monarch. They are, they're successive generations that migrate up, and then they fly back down to Mexico in one generation, all the way back. So monarch, we have a monarch wrangler program, and George and I are monarch wranglers at our ranch. Our campus around the Bush Library in SMU is a monarch wrangler. And just this week, I went to parks in Dallas that are built over freeways, and they're monarch wranglers. Our symposia series connects scholars, policymakers, and experts to discuss key topics related to natural resource conservation. And our third program is we try to communicate the story in our state in a way that activates new investments in conservation. Our Conservation Wrangler program, which we're celebrating today, because this school district is now a Conservation Wrangler, highlights the very best Texan-led conservation efforts occurring in our state. Texan by Nature supports select, innovative, and transformative projects in the field of conservation with tailored aid, resources, and visibility. And that's why I'm here, so we can get this out on television right here. If you'll see, we have a big bank of reporters, so that everyone in this part of the state knows that you all are conservation wranglers here, right here in your school districts. We designated the Lower Rio Grande Learning Landscapes Collaborative, which includes FAR San Juan and Alamo ISD, PSJA, as a Texan by Nature conservation wrangler for its work to create native habitat learning centers at schools throughout South Texas. The learning landscapes are made possible by support from the Santa Ana Wildlife Refuge, the National Wildlife Federation, and the Friends of the Wildlife Corridor. The collaborative's work to maintain natural landscapes on South Texas school grounds has a dual purpose. First, it ensures that local wildlife continues to prosper. All those monarchs and other birds and butterflies that use this flyway, flying up the center part of Texas to migrate, and it introduces students to nature early on, encouraging children to be active learners and leaders in preserving our native habitat for the next generation. And that's what I saw when I walked with children through this learning landscape, and that is how they already knew things about the plants that are here and how important they are and how to plant those Turk's cap that we were planting. And I also saw mist flowers, which will attract butterflies as well. One of the Learning Landscapes Collaborative's goal is to encourage other school districts in the Lower Rio Grande Valley to become National Wildlife Federation certified schoolyard habitat districts as well. The certified schoolyard habitat district requires that 50% of the schools within a district have a schoolyard habitat. Schoolyard habitats have great benefits. Research shows that being outside in nature contributes to our capacity for creativity, for problem solving, and for emotional and intellectual development. We all know that being outside in nature makes us feel good. And this is a sort of sad statistic. This generation of American children are outside less than any generation of people before us. Because what are we doing? We're inside on a screen. What kind of screen? Television or iPad or iPhone. So we want, when we were little, our parents said, go outside to play. And that's what we're hoping your parents will do to you too. Schoolyard habitats introduce students to the importance of conservation practices at a young age, spurring an appreciation for nature that will provide lifelong benefits for their health, and for our economy. And these outdoor spaces are vital for preserving wildlife, including iconic species such as the beautiful monarch butterfly. I believe that as Texans, it's in our nature to practice good stewardship of our precious wildlife and natural resources. Our relationship with the outdoors is an integral part of what it means to be a Texan. Through programs like the Lower Rio Grande Valley Learning Landscapes Collaborative, which incorporate conservation into the daily lives of children, teachers, and administrators, we can create a lasting positive impact for all Texans and for our beautiful natural world. The choices we make now will shape the world for the next generation. And that's why I thank each and every one, especially all of you, for choosing to make these efforts to build a culture of conservation at your schools and in your communities. Now I'm happy to introduce Colin O'Mara, the president and CEO of the National Wildlife Foundation. Federation. Thank you.
Well, good morning, Green Jays. So how many of you have planted a native plant in the amazing habitat behind the school? How many of you have actually gone out there and actually planted something yourself? So first of all, I want to thank you all for the opportunity to leave Washington, D.C., which is a fairly scary place on many days, to visit.
Have you seen
the green chase? I have. I've seen four already, which is amazing. Yeah. The work that you're all doing, and I apologize, I'm going to talk to the kids a little bit, so I apologize. The work that you're all doing here is some of the most important wildlife work in the entire country. There's about 6,000 schools across the country that have, 6,000, so a big number, that have some kind of schoolyard habitat. This one that you built with Mr. Williams and Principal Gonzalez and Dr. King is the best one in the entire country. And here's why it's so important. So right now, about one third of all wildlife, one out of three wildlife species need our help. And so Mrs. Bush talked about the monarch, but there's lots of other species too that we need to help. Because the problem is when things like pollinators, things like bees, things like different types of butterflies, when the numbers of them go down, there isn't enough pollinators to help with our crops in agriculture. There's not enough to help with our food. And so we have to help save these species. And so the work that you've done here, the work that you've done with the South Padre Mist and so many other species is helping bring back these populations. And the reason that is so important and the reason that we love working with Texan by Nature is that if we can take a great project like we did here and all the incredible teachers and the great leadership, and we can bring it to other school districts in this school district, and we can bring it to other school districts in other parts of the country, we can actually create an opportunity to save thousands of species. And so at the National Wildlife Federation, our big goal is to help save thousands of species by getting all of you to do your part for wildlife. So how many of you like to play outside more than you like to play inside? See, when I ask that question in some other parts of the country, folks actually look down because they don't want to raise their hand because they don't have some of these amazing spaces that you've all built together. Because right now, the average kid is spending hours and hours a day in front of screens and not playing outside. And I know it gets really hot here sometimes, and a lot hotter than when I grew up in a very cold part of the country in upstate New York. But playing outside is the best thing you can do as you want to learn and do better in school, and you want to become more creative, and you want to really develop into great conservationists in the future. So when you play outside, it helps with your problem solving, you're happier, You end up making friends better because you're working on projects together. It helps you do better in science and math and technology and all these different subjects. You'll actually do better in school. And if you do better in school, you'll get better jobs. And so there's nothing better that you can be doing than playing outside and building these great habitats and engaging with them. How many of you are members of the birding club that just started? What's your favorite bird that you've had a chance to see out here? And you can't say green jay because you're all fabulous green jays. What's your favorite bird?
Hummingbirds.
What other ones? Have you seen a hummingbird, maybe? Yep.
Mine are
the woodpeckers. Any other ones? Now, I've also heard you've seen some incredible mammals out here, things like javelinas, maybe armadillos, some amazing animals. So here's my request. We need to figure out ways to take the incredible lessons that you've all learned at having such an amazing school. You're at one of the most amazing schools in the entire country, and help other kids get excited. Because at the National Wildlife Federation, we want to make sure that every kid in America, in every single state, has the same opportunities that you're having. So I'm going to try to do everything I can, whether I'm in Alabama or Arkansas or Washington or West Virginia, and I'm going to be talking about Palmer Elementary School, because if you can do it here, we can replicate this over and over again. This is why the partnership's so important with the Lower Rio Grande Valley Learning Landscapes Collaborative, because you're creating a model here that can be replicated. And you're going to be the first school district in Texas to actually certify your entire school district as a wildlife habitat. That's amazing. And the reason it's so important, because then Mrs. Bush and I and the folks of Texans by Nature and the folks at Texas Parks and Wildlife, we can go to the folks in Houston, we can go to the folks in Austin, in San Antonio, saying, you all better catch up to the folks that are right here. Because we want to make sure that every kid across the entire state of Texas, the great state of Texas, and every part of the country has the same opportunity. So on behalf of the National Wildlife Federation, we can be prouder of our partnership with the Fish and Wildlife Service. And I'm going to be introducing some of the great leaders there in just a second. I cannot say enough about Dr. King and Principal Gonzalez and Alan and the team here. What you've built is truly special. And I'm really glad you guys gave me a chance to not have to be in Congress for a day, because it's not that fun right now. But to all the Green Jays in the room, you are awesome. You can do anything for wildlife, and together we're going to save all of wildlife populations across this country. So give me one quick round of applause for the wildlife in our country. And to the teachers and the school board and everything else, it's amazing what you're doing here. I just want you to know from the bottom of my heart how significant this work is, not just locally, not just regionally. You're transforming lives and creating a model that I'm hoping to spread across the entire country with the Federation. And it's just, you should all be very proud, so be very proud. And with that, I'm going to introduce one of the most important wildlife leaders in the entire country. It's someone that worked for an organization called the Bureau of Land Management for many years, which oversees hundreds of millions of acres out west. But now she's in charge of all the wildlife in Oklahoma and Texas and New Mexico and Arizona. And that's the head of the Southwest Office of the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, Amy Luters.
Well, good morning, everyone. How's everyone doing today? Good, great. Well, thank you so much for the opportunity to speak today. The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service is really proud to be a part of this effort that has involved so many people. I did first want, if my folks from the Santa Ana National Wildlife Refuge could stand, I want to acknowledge them. And these folks here are your neighbors and your partners and have done such amazing work. So I wanted to make sure I acknowledge all that you've been doing here. And Mrs. Bush, I certainly want to thank you and your staff for Texan by Nature for your strong support and leadership in terms of conservation in this great state. It really makes a huge difference. So thank you very much. We, with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, are so excited to work with communities, and no place is that more evident than here. The Lower Rio Grande Valley Learning Landscapes is an example of bringing partners together, teachers together, students together, leaders of the community together, to really make a difference not just for monarchs and pollinators and wildlife and habitat, but making a difference for our youth and what their future. And I'm looking forward in several decades for one of these students here to have a Fish and Wildlife Service shirt on and be up here and talking about the great values and how they learned it here in this school. So hopefully we can stay tuned for that into the future. All of us here know today, and as Mrs. Bush said, the work here in Texas is critical to saving the monarch butterfly. Texas is that funnel that is the migration highway, the intersection that connects their spring and summer breeding habitats with their winter habitats in Mexico. And that's why this learning landscape project is so important. It does great things for the monarch butterfly, but also teaches all of us about the beauty and the value of the natural resources that are part of our own backyard and literally here in the backyard, integrated into this school. And it was so exciting to be out there today, and we saw many of the students move, I think, from students to teachers in terms of all that they knew and could share with us about what they had learned. And so I was very impressed with how much you all had learned and how you were able to share with us all that you knew. When I look around and see the hard work and dedication, whether it be from the school leadership, whether it be from the teachers, whether it be from our partners, and especially all of you, it is truly impressive. As the mother of two boys, I know how important it is to have opportunities to enjoy nature, to understand it, to be problem solvers. And I think all of you have demonstrated that, but it took an entire community here to make this happen. So I appreciate everyone's leadership to making this happen. I personally am confident that not just the monarch butterfly, but all of America's wildlife is in good hands, and that you all will lead the way for us as we work in other parts of the nation, other parts in the region, to find ways to connect students and to have students be leaders in conservation. So thank you all for the opportunity to be part of this. Thanks to the Santa Ana team for all that your work in the communities working on partnerships like this. I'm pleased now to welcome all the way from our headquarters office in Washington, D.C., Cynthia Martinez, who is the chief of the National Wildlife Refuge System.
Thank you, Amy. Thank you, Green Jays. How special are you? Look at how many people came here to talk to you and tell you what a great job you're doing and how incredibly lucky you are, right? They've made a big deal that I'm from Washington, D.C. I live there. I work there. I came a long ways to be here with you. But really, I'm just a small town girl from New Mexico. The town I grew up in, it had two stoplights, right? So where you're growing up is a lot bigger. So sometime, someday, you could be one of us as well, right? So stay the course. This whole idea about connecting our kids with the outdoors, that's something that is ingrained in us that we've already all known, but somewhere along the line, we lost it. Some might say, why is the Fish and Wildlife Service so interested in this? Well, guess what? You know what I represent? I represent 566 national wildlife refuges across this country. That's 850 million acres of lands and waters that are set aside specifically to protect wildlife. We have refuges from Puerto Rico to Alaska to Guam. Think about that on the globe. It's huge, right? And I gotta tell you, we tend to attract biologists. Biologists, they're a little shy. They don't really know how to talk to people because they really care about the wildlife and that's what they wanna do, right? And so we established these national wildlife refuges, and for a long time we put up our blue goose signs and we'd be like, yeah, the best thing for wildlife is to keep the people out. And we came along and started questioning that, saying, wow, how well is that working for us? Yeah, not so much. And so we really took a look at ourselves and said, the way to manage wildlife and habitat is really to connect with people. We need that engagement, right? There's a lot of passion in each of these kids, but it's the adults that have to ignite that and keep that passion flaming for the outdoors, for conservation, for wildlife. Well, when we figured out that we really did need to connect with people, we also figured out we can't do this alone. It's way too much. But we can work with superintendents. We can work with principals. We can work with teachers. We can work with Texan by Nature, right? We can work because together it's a whole partnership. It takes all of us to buy into it and to then make it happen. We have three national wildlife refuges here in this valley. You've got Lower Rio Grande Valley, Santa Ana, Laguna Atascosa. I gotta tell you, it's pretty exciting. Just like Colin, I'm gonna be going everywhere and talking about Palmer Elementary School and the kids that I met and Cynthia, who shares a name with me.
We're going to tell this story. I've been to Yonkers, New York, at School 13. You Green Jays are lucky, because at School 13, they only had a very small concrete area, about that much of this room, that they had available to plant their gardens and their monarch areas. You guys have a whole backyard. That's pretty exciting. And so as we go across the country and we talk about this connection, it's really about those partnerships. It's about the people, the adults that get it, that are willing to come out and spend a little time with us and make things happen. This is what we have to do really for each other, for our children, for the future of the conservation of this country. I am so excited that you all invited me to be here and to spend a little time getting to know the students, seeing the trails, seeing the wonderful job that you're doing. If it weren't for folks like you, we wouldn't be able to make this happen. And this is a true example that you all have done here in the Lower Rio Grande Valley to make things happen. And I applaud you for that. It's been an honor for me to be here. Thanks for having me. And I believe that at this point, this concludes this part of our program. So thank you for all that you have done.